Now you're going 100 miles an hour, to your point. You're wrestling against the WWE champion. It's SmackDown. This is basically the pinnacle of what we're doing at the time. And you continued to build. It was like slow and steady. You started seeing a lot more Ali. We're approaching Elimination Chamber. You have the injury that you sustain. What's going through your head?
I don't want to say it's a hard topic for me, but it's I hate what ifs. I hate them, right? And there's nothing you can do about it. The thing happened with Randy. It was an accident, but my face got caved in. And, you know, I haven't really disclosed all of this, but as we all do, we get hit and we try to get back up.
Yep.
I got back up. I finished the match. I assured everyone I was fine. I really thought I was fine, to be fully clear. I wasn't hiding anything. I really thought it was just a really bad black eye. I knew where I was. You know, they did the test. I was good. And then later that night, I have to go back out, and Eric Rowan ends up grabbing me by the face and doing like the claw choke slam thing on the table. And I remember just laying on the table going, ah, man, the room is spinning right now. But again, systems check, I'm able to get up on my own. I go, okay, I feel fine, I'm okay. I get word that for next week, I'm in a gauntlet match. And now I'm realizing this is my moment. They're building me up going into this big Elimination Chamber pay-per-view for the WWE Championship. This is what I've been working for my entire life, 17 years of, you know, the whole blood, sweat, and tears, broken bones, missing everything. Like, this is it. This is my moment. And we have like a live event loop leading into that TV. And I don't even remember the matches, but I just remember instances of like the room spinning and I'm having trouble breathing and this and that. And there was at one point, it was a tag match. I take a turnbuckle, which I've taken a million times, and I'm out on my feet and somehow finish the match. And that was it, man. I remember like sitting in the hotel room that night, trying not to cry, because I know there's no way they're going to let me perform on SmackDown. And because of that, there's no way. And I'm, you know, how long, you know, what's the, you know, can I come back in 5 days? And they go, dude, you're out for a while. You know, the announcements made that Kofi's replacing me. And then we all know what happens, man.
Kofi goes on this historic run. That launched Kofi Mania.
Right. And it's like, okay, silver lining, right? Great guy gets this awesome opportunity, but you don't know. Because all I know is I was about to beat five of the best on SmackDown going into Elimination Chamber. And let me ask you, do you not think that I could steal the show inside Elimination Chamber, knowing what I'm capable of? That was my night. So I guarantee you I was heading to WrestleMania. And that's where all this baggage and this what if and this thing that's going to drive me crazy for the rest of my life. What if I didn't get hurt?
Not to put the cart before the horse, but now Mustafa Ali and Retribution are Monday Night Raw. You guys have free reign of the place. What are you looking forward to for not only yourself, but the rest of Retribution in the months to come?
Look at what I'm saying, what we're doing. I am making a promise and a warning to every Raw superstar that just because you're done with the past doesn't mean the past is done with you. Every single one of us have been wronged in the past. So we have made it our personal mission to be judge, jury, and executioner. Your sins aren't forgiven until they're punished. This is Retribution's motto. So anyone that has done wrong, good or bad, anyone, if you've done wrong, Retribution will find you. And I think that's a really interesting dynamic because you don't know who's next.
Well, I was almost next because someone swung a baseball bat and nearly took my head clean off my shoulders. And I didn't do anything wrong.
I sent an email to that guy right away. He was taking care of it. I said, you don't mess with Corey gets a pass. Corey's taking care of me.
I appreciate that. Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe now and never miss an episode.